Thank you everybody for being a part of this. This is pretty exciting. I just want to know, how much can we get out of these computers?
This is the ultimate ultra test. Have you ever noticed when Apple releases a new computer, one thing they brag about is how many streams of ProRes it can play back at one time? Check this out. The best Apple computer you can buy at the time of this recording is a Mac Studio M3 Ultra. And apparently it's capable of playing back 18 streams of 8K ProRes? What's the point of that? Seriously, why even market it? How often does anyone have 24 ProRes 8K files loaded into a single timeline and they need to play them all back at exactly the same moment? This must be one of those useless features that Apple can just justify jacking up the price on what's already a really expensive computer. Or is it? If you haven't been paying attention, back in 2020, Apple had one of those one more thing moments and announced that they would be transitioning away from Intel to an ARM instruction set.
Today is the day we're announcing that the Mac is transitioning to our own Apple Silicon.
This new custom processing architecture known as M Series turns an off-the-shelf computer into quite literally a supercomputer that you can own. And that made me realize something. If you take a look at the conventional way most companies offer compute power as part of their business value prop, they tend to position that power in the cloud. Cloud computing has become the standard way that we believe we get more power, more accessibility, and more speed into our workflows. But that's not what Apple's doing. In fact, in a way, they're betting against it by spending billions of dollars to enhance compute not to run in the cloud, but to run at the edge. So what does that mean? Well, it means either Apple's wasting money or they know something. Now, what would be the point of having enough compute to actually have a single computer play back 24 streams of ProRes simultaneously? Well, we have a new idea. So we got our hands on an M3 Ultra and we invited 20 people to join us from around the world, not to play back 20 streams of simultaneous ProRes in a single location, but to see if the M3 Ultra could play back 20 streams of simultaneous ProRes to 20 different locations. Now, why would we do something that ridiculous? Well, to answer that, you need to understand why we're building Strada. If you haven't already, go back and watch episodes 42 and 43, where we discuss how our business has changed based on the feedback from users like you. Roughly 100 days ago, we released Strada Agents. Agents allows you to remotely share thousands of video, audio, and stills to your collaborators without having to upload anything to a cloud. Since releasing it, more than 3,000 people have signed up to use it. Our users have connected thousands of drives, invited hundreds of collaborators, and shared terabytes of media, all from their own local drives, and paid zero in cloud storage costs. But throughout hundreds of conversations that we've had with early users, there was one question people overwhelmingly ask the most often. Can you edit these files? I've been editing for 2/3 of my life, and the options to get footage from the set to an editor essentially boils down to 4 configurations. The first configuration is the most common. You have a local computer connected to a local drive. Direct attached storage means you can browse, playback, and edit files instantly without transcoding or rendering, which makes it an ideal experience for the editor. Direct attached local storage also means you can work with original camera files that are large, like ProRes 4K. Another benefit is it doesn't require you to have high bandwidth internet in order to playback terabytes of media, and the setup is plug and play. But there is one major drawback to local storage solutions. You have to physically deliver files to the editor, and the media on these drives isn't accessible to remote members of your teams. That leads us to the second configuration, which is fully remote. This makes collaboration easy because your team can all connect to the same remote tools. But it's not an ideal experience for an editor because it's not your computer. Therefore, you don't always have access to your own presets or libraries, fonts, and other personal resources. But because it's remotely controlled, it is possible to work with large original camera files, and you typically only need about 10 megabits of bandwidth for these solutions to perform well. But systems like this are complex to set up and often require support to keep them running efficiently, which is why they're not as popular with small teams or individuals. That leads us to the third configuration, which is local computer and cloud transfer. This is great for the editor because the media can be edited locally. These tools are easy to set up and can be used to deliver media to anyone on your team who also needs a copy. But because you have to transfer through a cloud service, these tools rely on upload and download speeds in order to work, which means using them to access original camera files is time-consuming and expensive. That's why some people like the fourth configuration, which is local computer and a virtual media cache. Products like LucidLink, Suite Studios, and Shade are all cloud services that trick your computer into thinking the media is local by mounting a virtual file system on your desktop. This makes it ideal for the editor because they're using their own machine and they can choose to have access to original camera files, and one source of media in the cloud can be shared with all collaborators at the same time. But setting these systems up requires help to manage the connection and collaboration aspects. It also leans completely on your bandwidth in order to playback media. Since these are clouds, they're expensive to store and require a lot of bandwidth to perform, unless you use them to transfer or pin the files locally, which actually makes these products behave more like a higher priced version of configuration number 3. Now, all the products here are good products. I've got experience with all of them. And everyone watching probably uses one or two of these configurations in order to get footage from cameras to your editor. And if you're like me, you've found ways to make them work. But their drawbacks are a constant motivator to explore alternative solutions. That's why I want to know, what would it look like if we could take the parts of these workflows that we like and eliminate all the drawbacks? This is a new category, which we can call local computer, that uses local media streaming technology to access it. Is this even possible? And where do you even begin to make it happen? Well, that's what Strada is all about. It's also where we combine Strada with the power of Apple M-Series chips. Now, that works great for one remote interaction, but if you can't have multiple people access files at the same time, there's no point to trying to edit off these files. So what we need is a proof of concept that our technology might be capable of having multiple people play huge files virtually, thousands of miles away, without uploading or downloading at the same time on average internet. So to do this test, we needed a little help from our friends.
Thank you, everybody, for being a part of this. This is pretty exciting. I just want to know, how much can we get out of these computers?
We put the word out to an international group of Strada users and wanted to see how many people could play back ProRes 4K off of one Mac computer in my house in Los Angeles. To do this all at the same time, we needed to set up my living room with a series of different Apple Silicon computers to test so we could learn the limits of what each model was capable of.
If you think about it, these computers themselves are like little supercomputers. Individually, computers like these Apple Silicon machines are actually more powerful than a single machine in AWS. And so what we're going to learn today is the answer to a question that a lot of people have been asking us. How many people can play a ProRes 4K file off of a single Mac Silicon machine?
We used RAIDs and SSDs from OWC, Glyph, and ProGrade to ensure playback speeds weren't a factor in performance. We connected those drives to several different models of Apple Silicon computers, ranging from the original M1s to brand new M4s. Then, using Strada, we invited our participants to different drives so that each individual would be able to play back the ProRes XQ 4K file when we asked them to. With everyone on the call ready to go, I asked them one by one to start playing so that we could count the performance of each stream.
Tony, Jack, and Drew, give me a thumbs up if you're playing. Great. Great, great. Now, Myron and Seth. Yep, okay. Noah and Alex loaded into the player. Hajun and Jamin loaded into the player. All right, Willis and Hero, give me a thumbs up. Is everybody else still playing from before? Okay. Khalif, JR, and Clyde loaded into the player. Ooh, that's good. We're getting deep. Okay. Luca, Christian, and Sam. Oh my gosh, okay. And now, Pallavi, Evan, and Lewis. Give us a thumbs up. Who is still playing? Who is still playing? Oh, that's good, okay.
Still playing,
smooth. Whoa, that's nuts. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I think we just got maybe 20 people.
And there you have it. 20 simultaneous streams of a 1 gigabit per second ProRes XQ 4K file being played back with sync sound literally across the globe by 20 different people off a single computer connected to only 30 megabits of upload speed in my home in Los Angeles. We have filmmakers literally all over the world. Indonesia, Greece, Tahiti, Germany, Spain, New York, Atlanta, Minneapolis. We literally linked up people 10,000 miles away from each other to my Strada account in Los Angeles. No one had any issues accessing my computer or the files I shared with them. The ProRes files are being viewed in 10-bit color and 4K resolution, and they aren't pre-transcoded, they're not cached, they're being live streamed. This means our ProRes video source bandwidth is 600 times greater than our available upload bandwidth. If you want to see the results of every computer, check out strada.tech where you can see the performance of your configuration. What this proves is Strada can scale like a cloud, only it works without a cluster of machines, just one computer. This also proves Strada's unique architecture can overcome a huge hurdle that we don't think anyone's ever jumped before. But there's something that we can't yet do. We can't yet edit these files directly. We have to download them locally. But since Strada doesn't require cloud storage, this can be done faster and cheaper than products like Google Drive, Dropbox, or Signiant. And even though we played 20 files simultaneously, Strada can't play infinite files. But if you don't need more than 20 simultaneous people playing back ProRes 4K all at exactly the same time, this solution is easy to set up in seconds, and it doesn't require any cloud uploading or cloud storage. So what's next? The answer is taking our tech stack and turning it into a virtual file system. Think about it. If we can get that working, that would allow 20 remote editors to load these files directly into timelines without ever having to transfer them or transcode them or upload them from one computer. This would mean you can open a file in your edit software while the file is on someone else's desk at home. And with any luck, that can even be a raw file. That's the ultimate goal that our team is working towards, and it's why you should sign up for Strada today and join us on this journey of a reinvented form of collaboration. Speaking of that, in the next episode, we're going to take Strada onto a set and see what it can do with the current features. And trust me, we're about to show the fastest delivery of edit files from a set to an editor, maybe ever. And if you know my history, that means something very significant is about to happen.